time for the guided meditation. And again, my gratitude for letting me move it to this time. And the guided meditation, like many other things here, is optional. For those who have meditated a lot, sometimes all you need is just the space, the place, conditions, and off you go. However, that some who's even meditated many, many times can appreciate a little bit of a boost. And also, it gives a few extra skillful means. So, I always like to introduce different little methods, skillful means to get to the same place, which is, of course, the mind becoming aware and still. So, with your eyes closed, as usual, we become aware of our body. Understanding outside is safe. The body is not too warm, not too cold, hopefully somewhere in between. And no one is looking at you, checking you out. You have no test to pass. It's like you're by yourself. There may be other people next to you. In meditation, it's as if we're alone, safe, calm. Then we can start to feel our body. I do recommend starting with the furthest part from your head, even the toes. Can you feel your toes now? If you can't, wiggle your toes. If that doesn't connect you, your brain is your toes, you can even touch them. So you make contact. You can feel your toes. It's as if that's the only thing you're aware of. And see if you can relax them. People thought this was crazy. What do you mean relaxing your toes? Just make the suggestion. You find the toes do relax. The feeling becomes more open, less tight. And just being aware of your toes, with your eyes closed, you feel they start to tingle. Tingle with relaxation. Sometimes all somebody needs is to be recognized with care and they feel safe and relaxed, just like parts of your body. When your toes are settled, you move up to your feet, the soles, the heels, the uppers. Can you notice any sensations there? If you can, then you've made contact. Make contact between your mind and your feet. How do your feet feel? Very rarely you check up on them, except when they're really cold or they've been injured. deeply even imagine soaking your feet. Imagine what it was like soaking your feet in hot, salty water. To relax them. Open up the pores. Loosen any tight muscles. Soothe any little blood vessels and bones. Is your focus just on your feet, the bones, the skin, and the heels? Feeling and relaxing and soothing. As if you're giving yourself a foot massage. Soft. Calming. Healing. And then you move up from your heels to your ankles. How do your ankles feel? Is there aches there or some injury? Even some arthritis? You feel sensations. You get to know them. Get to understand aches, pains, inflammations by being with them. And after a while you get to know what makes them worse and what makes them less of a problem. It's always the case in my experience that kindness, compassion, warmth, allowing them to be, makes any pain less intense. Remember the lady who sent an email to our admin in our city centre about how she totally overcame her chronic arthritis. It's like a miracle. Just by being aware and patiently, day after day, relaxing the immune response to the arthritis. To relax so much, it vanished. So I'm just focusing on the feeling in my feet, sorry, in my ankles. I feel quite nice. Relax, release. And now it's time to move up my legs, to my calves, some muscles on the back of my lower legs, skin around the bone. I'm looking for any feeling at all there, any sensation, anything that I can make contact with. Mind to the body. And I don't try to control. I try and control those feelings. They just get more tight, more tense. They rebel. Instead, I soothe. I'm kind. I imagine those muscles together with the bone and the skin. I imagine them just laying on the softest of cotton cushions. Relax, at ease, pampered. When I imagine those muscles and the bone and the skin of my lower legs, just my lower legs, relaxing. Imagine any tightness expanding. anything which is squashed, like a sponge which has been wrung out, and loosen it all. So the sponge takes its natural soft shape. So my legs expand, become soft, light. All I'm doing is just focusing on that one area of my body. Or that twin area, if you like, the left and the right. Until my legs, the calves, become so relaxed. At ease. As if they too have been massaged. And then I go up to my knees. Almost 50 years I've been sitting on the ground meditating. My knees, very rarely do they ache. One of the reasons is that I look after them, I care for them, I feel them with my mind. Feel these knees. Kind to them, relax them. I really get to know any sensation there which needs attention. Just a small part of my body, just the two knees and the back of the knees as well. And the skin and the bones, and I'm kind to them. I relax every part of that, two parts of my body, those joints, every part. It's like oiling a sort of a movable joint in some sort of apparatus. I'm not using real oil, I'm using kindness. Warmth, gentleness. I'm just being aware. Just as the knees, relaxing, healing. Sometimes you may get some warmth there, some heat, just by attention, to try and heal any injury which may have happened. Then I move up when I feel I'm finished with my knees. If you've had injuries there, stay much longer. If there's pain, tightness, stay there. And just learn, sometimes by trial and error. Try this. No, that never worked. Try something else. What you're changing is attitudes of mind. The way you look at that part of your body, your perception of it. And then you recognize how your perception affects the well-being of that part of your body. How feelings of kindness, trust, letting be, open the door of your heart. Care. All those positive ways of looking. Focus just on your deep knees. How it relaxes them. You get the feedback. At first, you can do a little. But every time you learn, you become more skilled. Until sometimes you can just observe a knee which is aching, then snap it into comfort with kindfulness. And then you move to your thighs, these huge pair of muscles. And I can feel them just the thighs. I've made contact with them. My left thigh is aching a little bit. No clue why. But I'm kind to it. I feel it. Relax it. Imagine opening it out. Imagining that no tightness, a guitar string, when stretched, makes a noise when something hits it. When you loosen both ends, the guitar string becomes so loose, so stress-free, when something impinges on it. Just need a register. I'm doing that to my left thigh. Relaxing it to the max. Feeling to loosen. Loosen, loosen, loosen. And I can feel you getting totally at peace. A little way up, I have my buttocks. When you meditate a lot sitting on a cushion, on a chair, there's a lot of pressure on your bottom. Many of those muscles are compressed. But it doesn't mean you can't relax them. Imagine them just opening up, relaxing. Loosening, still pressed, but I'm not adding, increasing the pressure on my bottom. I'm almost imagining that becoming free without any force, without any pressure, just being, just the muscles in my butt. Just winning them well-being and kindness and gentleness. All your muscles which I compress so many times during the day may be happy now. Free. If I can give loving kindness to the cement mixer. So easy to give it to the muscles in your own butt. Feel less pressure on my butt. Should be the case, it's the same weight, haven't moved, but it feels that way. Then I move up to my waist. That waist has got a lot of things going on inside. Important parts of your body, vital organs. I don't know too much about anatomy, but I imagine them. They're important parts of my family, my bodily family. So I wish them all well. Your anus. The urinary tract, bladder, all this. I'm kind to them, wishing them well, giving them some attention. And again, if you've got the irritable bowel syndrome, sometimes it's because of neglect. You've never said thank you, been kind, paid attention to that part of your body. So if you've got any tightness, ache there, don't avoid it, focus on it. Zoom in on it. Like you see a person on the street who's hungry or who's cold. You give them something. You don't just avoid them. You give them some kindness. Even just a smile. And they appreciate it. They aren't cared for, the abused. These are parts of your own body. So if you have any aches or tightnesses or tensions or pain in that part of your body, you focus, smile, give kindness. And often I can feel that tightness, that tension lessen. It diminishes. It's like I'm stroking it, like I used to stroke somebody, their hair, to make them go asleep. They were afraid. They were in pain. Whenever I played on the streets, played soccer, I made a tackle and scraped the skin off my knees. And bleeding, I'd run to my mum. And she would simply crouch down and kiss it better. And soon she kissed it. The kindness, the attention from your own mother took all the pain away. I didn't understand why. I just knew it always worked. Just as if you, by giving attention and kindness to your low intestines, colon, you're relaxing. Sometimes in life we just, oh, we abuse our body. Sometimes got not much choice. We're in a rush. Then we only got a certain diet. But now you say sorry. You feel that part of your body with your mind. You're making contact. And you're easing it. Sometimes you have this attitude and it gets tighter, it doesn't work. You're going in the wrong direction. Try something else. Ah, that's kindness. Because the tightness, the tension eases. How your own mind affects your own body. Parts of it. Until that part of your body feels so loose. It's as if you have soaked the insides of the lower part of your body in warm water. Eased everything. You can't actually get to it because it's inside unless you cut things out, and that's not nice. But now, with your own mind, you're almost like massaging that part of your body. Massaging it internally with your mind. Easing it, loosening it. The degree of kindness is crucial. Feeling it, easing it. And hopefully you feel those bowels, the low intestines, become ache-free. And then you move up a little bit. See what else? Just above. It may be, you know, I sometimes get lost because a long time since I did biology. But imagine the kidneys and the liver, spleens, the other part of the intestines. Oh, and also the spine. All of those links in your spine, which can sometimes get damaged and in pain. I check all those vertebrae. Feel them. As I just move up, imagine, don't have to know which one is which. up we go. If I find any of them which is aching or in pain or not normal, I pause with my mind. I wish them well being. Little vertebrae and that little pad between the next one. I care for you. We give a loving kindness, so it relaxes. It responds, even part of your own body. You go inside from there. It may be your stomach. It may be blood vessels, I don't know. But I go in there and I, as if with my mind, I feel sensations. If I find any tightness there, any tension, I linger. I linger and make peace with it. Kind, again, like you are, massaging things. Sometimes if you've got an injury, or you can massage in some arnica or it is, I don't know what other oils, papaya cream or whatever. You can do that on the outside, as if you're imagining doing this on the inside. Anything bruised or injured or inflamed, you imagine your mind going inside your body and applying the ointment of loving kindness, compassion. Really just gently rubbing it in through a stomach which is aching, through vertebrae which is in pain. Feel your kind. And it actually works. Inside my own body, it relaxes and eases. And go up even further to your lungs. These great airbags. And imagine them. Imagine giving a gentle clean with all of the pollution in our world, all of the irritating, I don't know what, all in your lungs. Imagine relaxing them, easing them. It's when you're breathing in the next bit of air, it's not ordinary oxygen. This is oxygen which goes into your airways, bronchioles, just eases the whole of your lungs, clean them, invigorate them, energize them. You feel the whole lungs, both sides, appreciating your attention and your kindness. Invigorating. And especially for the females, to your breasts. Really, so much, many women get breast cancer. So just check your own breasts to feel them with your mind. Check them. Men get breast cancer too. So you feel those breasts. How are they? If you feel anything which is a little bit imbalanced, something a bit not right, it's hard to put names on these feelings. You pause on them with your own mind. You ease them, wish them well, kind to them, expand any tightness, soothes any irritation. And of course, with practice, you get quite skilled at soothing tumours, shrinking them with your own mind, relaxing all the muscles around, caring, soothing, appeasing. Just even focusing your attention there. Sometimes you can feel energy going there. Just by focusing. Heat, warmth, or if you like, a golden light of healing power. Imagine a golden light. And it goes to that part of your body. Relaxing, healing. If you have cardiac problems, just imagine your heart and all these little pipes coming into it, called the arteries and veins. And just give it kindness and gratitude. If you learn to relax your heart, don't go to your heart first of all, because so many people have fear. And when they have fear, they interfere. And the heart becomes just not relaxed. So at this stage, you can wish your heart well-being. Just let it. Just be very calm with them. It doesn't need to breathe much, to beat fast. The body is relaxed. It's just purring like an engine of a car when it's in idle mode. Just ticking over. As you're with your own heart and arteries, your cardiac system, relaxing, easing, loving, giving you respect. And go up further. Those are such an important part of your own body. You don't need to feel a victim. You can participate in the health of your vital organs, just through mindfulness and kindness, paying attention. And I go up to my shoulders. I go to my shoulders. Sometimes you don't get killed by tension in the shoulders, but sometimes we do have tightness there. I know the feelings in our shoulders so well. I just tell them to relax muscles. Just like sometimes you teach people who come to a meditation retreat with a smile, with a soft voice, relax. And I'll do that to my muscles. Relax, shoulders. And they know me. They know what to do. Everything gets really loose. So I can hardly feel any tension there at all. So I go to my shoulders. Sometimes I just give them a little bit of a movement. Just to make sure things are fine. But I didn't notice any feelings in my arms now. It's strange, but the arm holding the microphone is actually quite comfortable. It's the other arm. I feel a little bit of a tightness in my left upper arm. Pay attention, and I relax. I relax and relax and relax, and I feel that part of the loosening and loosening. Let go into my elbow, both elbows. Oh, sometimes accidents, a bit of mindlessness, and you hit them. You feel those elbows, and you wish them well. Really feel them. Any tightness, any pain, any unusual feelings. See what's necessary to lessen the intensity of those disturbing feelings. So if you do have any inflammation which might lead to arthritis, you can nip it in the bud. Feel it, relax it, pay attention with kindness. It feels good. It's like now you're rubbing this beautiful kindness cream into your joint. You're just really appreciating it. You may think it's a placebo, but who cares, it works. The elbow relaxes. The attention is more than anything the key to healing and relaxing. The fear is what makes everything tense and worse. And then I go down my forearms to feel the muscles. Sometimes I can even feel the blood throb with the beat of the heart. Go down to my wrists. People get aches and inflammations on the wrists too. It's like, how are you going down there, wrists? I don't care for you. Feel them. Soothe them, relax them, opening them out. Don't without even moving, I imagine them opening and soothing. Even your hands and your fingers. Actually, I remember an article, but if you focus on a part of your body, the blood goes there, or something goes there, and it gets warm and hot. I'm focusing on my fingers, my thumb. All those really important, useful parts of my body, which I use hundreds of times every day and never say thank you. Never give them much attention until something goes wrong and it hurts. But before it hurts, before there's an injury, I become mindful of my thumb and fingers. So I'm so aware of just that one part of my body, zooming in on it, to the exclusion of other parts of my body, to the exclusion of other things in life. Just being aware of my fingers and thumbs and palms of the hands and back of the hands. Feeling it as fully as possible, experiencing the sensations and relaxing them to the max. Feel that tingle. That's my word for it. I don't know. It feels just so at ease. It is as if that you just put your hand in this warm, healing water. Soft. Re-energizing. And then, even reluctantly, I go up to back to my shoulders and my neck. Just many people have got coughs here. I don't know whether allergy coughs or cold coughs or whatever. So sometimes I just become aware of the irritation in my throat. My poor throat, this time of my life I have to use it so much to give Dhamma talks. Thank you, throats, the vocal cords. Thank you so much for helping me share Dhamma. And just that bit of kindness, just my throat becomes clear, feels good. So many parts of you serve you selflessly, tirelessly. And all they ask for is a little bit of appreciation and kindness. And they respond. They relax. Same as the outer part of your throat, your neck. Sometimes the way we move our head, our poor neck, has to take a lot of stress. I feel those muscles in my neck with my mind and relax all of them. Head, if you want to go forward, fine. If you want to go back, fine. Just look out to the neck on which you stand, please. They're important, neck, to me. So I feel it and relax every part of it. There are two arteries, the carotid arteries, come on either side. Giving all this energy and blood to my brain. I care for you too. Strange feeling in the arteries. But it's good. Give up my throat to my mouth and jaws. Well, I really ask you to do a lot. Not just talking but eating. So I feel you, the muscles and the jaws. I give this beautiful kindness, gratitude, thank you. No feeling, I'm not trying to get rid of the feeling of the jaw. I'm just accepting you, saying thank you, acknowledging, being kind, opening the door of my heart, letting you be. And the feedback shows me things relax. I go up to my nose, my old itchy nose, sensitive to no pollen and other stuff. Sometimes I scratch you during meditation while other people aren't watching. Put my finger up you to try and get some clotted yuck out of you so I can breathe more freely. My nose. Don't pay much attention to you, but you're important to me. And I feel the nose not just to watch the breath, but to be kind to my nose. Relaxing it, not taking it for granted. Relaxing all the muscles in my nose. It's not so itchy anymore. Mindfulness gives me that feedback. Things change when you're aware and kind. Change for the best. And then I go up to my eyes. They're not seeing, they're closed. But sometimes we tend to screw those eyes shut. Why people have tension around the eyes? So I feel those muscles around the eyes and relax into the mind. loosen them. Like something is being pulled and I loosen it. So even like those muscles, I imagine, being massaged, soothed. So there's no tightness in them anymore. Everything feels so free. If your ears have an inflammation or tightness or tension, you can just go there too. Just feel them. How are your ears now? On either side. If you have any ache in there, it's amazing. You can just be with them. Relax it until it vanishes. You're helping the body become peaceful. And last but not least, go right between your two ears, a couple of inches behind your eyes, to what you can imagine as the center of your overwhelmed, abused brain. I say abused because we make it think too much. We have a problem, we force it to find a solution. And even when we should be sleeping, we're thinking. So imagine your mindfulness right in the center of this thing called your brain. Say sorry to your brain for making it think too much. Be kind to it. Give this beautiful energy. Relaxing it. Almost like massaging it. Almost like expanding any bruised or wounded part of your brain. Just focusing on it brings the warmth of healing and soothing. Now you've relaxed your whole body. How does it feel? All the time you've been mindful and focused, centered. The mind has achieved a state of stillness, and kindness, and ease. If ever you are sick or ill, this is amazing how this works. If ever you want to do long meditations, look after your body first. And you can know how from here, the relaxed body, you go so deep. You're doing the same with your mind. I'll be quiet for 5 minutes, and I'll ring the gong.
did go over time as usual. So, make it a 10-minute break. Then we have a sutta class. Is that okay? Okay, those who want to just stretch their legs or go to the toilet. 10-minute and then we have sutta class.
Mm-hmm.